Hi there, Jamie Keed here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how to use the COUNTIF and COUNTIFS functions inside Microsoft Excel. So I'll be showing you as a basic function and formula with the COUNTIF, but I also want to show you how you can add things like wildcards in and perform operations with the COUNTIF, and also how to use multiple criteria with the COUNTIFS function. Let's get started with this today on Teachers Tech. If you want to follow along today on this tutorial, I'll put the link to this worksheet down below in the description, and then you can click on it, make a copy, or download it to your computer. If you notice, this is very similar to my SUMIF and SUMIFS worksheet. So if you want to take a look at that video to learn how that function works, I'll put a link to that below in the description in the card up above. And if you're looking to learn other function and formulas inside Microsoft Excel, I'll put the link to that playlist. So let's start with the basics of COUNTIF, and I'm just going to start with a simple example here, and that's with this region code. I'm just going to count up how many of a certain number there using that function. When we start any formula, we're going to go ahead, click in the cell where we want it, put our equal sign to start, and I'm using the COUNTIF, so I'm just typing COUNTIF. You can see I have the option right here. I'm going to go ahead and select that. Now I said I'm going to look at the region code. I want to see how many times 1, 2, 3 comes up. So I go ahead and select my range like this, add a comma, and now I can say what I'm looking for. And when you're typing that in, you need to use your quotation marks. So I'm looking for 1, 2, 3. I end my quotation marks and then I have to end my bracket here and hit enter. And you can see 1, 2, 3 comes up 4 times. Here's the first one, second one, third, and fourth. Now, I just want to point out cell reference too. So I'm going to go to this spot here, and I'm going to start my COUNTIF formula again. And you see there it comes up. And this time, I just want to use a cell reference. So I'm going to go ahead and use the same range. It's going to be this range right here that I want. And I want to give a cell reference where I'm going to type it in here. So notice there's nothing there right now, but I'm going to click on it and end it and hit return. It comes back as 0. But now with a cell reference, I can quickly type something here that I'm looking for. So if I'm looking for a 341, I can type 341, hit enter, and it quickly gives me the 3 back because 341 shows up 3 times here. And I can change this number very quickly and get it to return. So cell references can make it easier. All right, let's go on to our next example with COUNTIF. So that's just with searching basic numbers, how many times it appears. But I can also do things like greater than or less than, and I'll just give you a greater than example. So I'm going to go to start my formula again. I'm going to go with my equal sign, type in COUNTIF, and it's right here. And this time my range is going to be in this one here. So now I'll say I want to look, I could use different operations. I could use equal, greater than, less than, but I'm just using the greater than here. So I'm going to go ahead and put my comma in, and now it's asking for the criteria. And this is where I'm going to put my quotation mark, and I'm going to say greater than 15,000 here. So 15,000, just like this, and my quotation mark and my other parenthesis, and I'm going to hit enter, and now it finds 5 that are greater than 15,000 here. So you can go ahead and count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, I just want to point out cell reference, and I'm going to do this again. So if I go equals and type my COUNTIF formula here, we can make sure my fingers are in the right place. So COUNTIF, and I go ahead and start it this time. So again, my range is here, just like this, but this time I'm going to reference this cell. Again, I haven't put anything in yet, and I'm just going to end it and hit enter. You can see 0. But if I want to find, let's say, anything greater than 10,000 now, I can just type in my greater than 10,000 like this, hit enter, and it gives me back 7 that are greater than 10,000. So I can use the cell reference for that also. Now, I also want to point out on our next example here, I've showed you with numbers, but we can be looking up, different letters in here or words. So if I go to this again and hit my equals and my COUNTIF, and select that one. And let's say we're looking in this one, my range is here, my comma. If it's not a cell reference, I have to use my quotes here. So let's say I'm looking for north. Then I type in what I'm looking for. Again, spell it correctly. And end it and end my other bracket. Hit return and it can find 3 north in here. Again, I'll leave this for you to practice, but you can go ahead and type north in one of these spots and then use the cell reference. So you can even use operations with the COUNTIF. So if you wanted to add it up multiple things in one column. So in this case, I want to see how many 1, 2, 3s and 3, 4, 1s. I could add 2 different COUNTIFs up. So if I go to this spot right now and use my equals, and I'm going to go to my COUNTIF here. And this time I'll go ahead, select my range here, just like this. And I'm going to just use, and this time I'm not using cell references, but you could on this one. So I'm just going to put 1, 2, 3, just like this here, and end my quotation. And then I'm going to put in this bracket and I'm going to add this time. So I'm going to go ahead, put just the add sign, and I'm going to do another COUNTIF here. So I'll go COUNTIF and select this. And what do I want? Well, it's the same range. So I'm going to select this one again. Put my comma, what am I looking to add right here? So I'm going to use my quotation mark. I'm going to put 3, 4, 1 in and my quotation mark. And now I should be able to hit, and it's going to be 7. So I've added up the 4, 1, 2, 3s and the 3, 3, 4, 1s, and it got a total of 7. You can perform other operations with this too. So if I just go back and I'm just going to make a quick change to this. So this was adding 3 plus 4. If I go back over to here and just make a change to this here, I'm going to put multiply. So now it's going to multiply 3 times 4 and give me 12, because it's not multiplying these numbers, it's multiplying the count of the 2 numbers that I did. So you could do this with different operations if that's what you're looking for. All right, let's move over to wildcards, and I want to give you a couple examples. Wildcards can be a great way to really speed up what you're searching for. And what they do is they take the place of something and can skip over something and look for something more specifically that you want. So for an example, let's give you a simple one. And we're gonna look at this name list. And I just wanna see anybody that starts with the letter A. Now, if I go and start my COUNTIF formula here, and I wanna see how many people start with the letter A. So my range is gonna be this. Inside here. So I'll put my comma, give my quotation mark, and I'm just going to put A. Now I need to put the star after just like this, because that will say, well, look for the A and whatever comes after does not matter. So I'm going to go ahead, end my bracket, hit return, and I get 1. So this looked through this list. If anything started with an A, it gave me back 1. So let's just change this a little bit, and I'm just going to modify this formula. So I'm going to just take out the star and the A, and I'll type in Ned. So you can see if I hit return, it brings me back 0. There is a Ned in here, but there's a Ned Stark, and I don't want the Stark to matter in this. I just want Ned. So if I go right into here, add my star like this, hit return, you can see now it's over to 1. All right, so what I want to do this time, and I'm just going to go ahead and copy this formula here and go over to this cell here. I'm just going to paste it in just like this. So I'll just paste in the formula. You can see it's the same. I'm going to modify this one. Now, in this case, I actually want to look for last names, and I want to look for how many Starks there are. So notice that in this case, the Ned and Star, how it is, if I just double click in here, I'm going to modify it from here. So if I go and actually put my star first this time, so I'm going to get rid of this, put my star first, and now I'm going to type Stark like this. And everything else can stay the same. Make sure that this is inside your quotes. I'm going to hit enter, and it has 3. So now it kind of bypassed the first letter here in that star, and now I could just write Stark, and then it found me 3 Starks, 1, 2, 3. So that's just some examples for wildcards. Let me show you one more. Another example of a wildcard that you could use would be a question mark. So if I was going to just type in, I'll use the COUNTIF here, and this one over here, I'll just use this right here to kind of give a simple demonstration. This is my criteria here. And if I go ahead and pick what I want to be looking for, so the question mark, so if I was looking for put in the question mark, so I'm saying it to ignore the first two spots and looking for the third one. So in this case, if I was looking for anything that had an H in there and ended it, it will give me one back. If I quickly go ahead and change this one, if it's looking for anything in with a C, it gives me two spots. So the question marks here can tell you to skip over a certain spot and then only look for the one that you're left with. And you can use different numbers of question marks on it. So the COUNTIFs are used if you have multiple criteria, if you're looking through two different ranges, and you could do two or three or more. I'm just going to show you with an example of two criteria here. And I'll go to this cell right here, and we'll start with our equal. And I'm going to type in COUNTIFs. And what I want to have happen this time, I want to look for anything above 22 in this column. That will give me back and compare it to if there's a stark there. So I'm going to have to use wildcards too. So my first is my range. So I'm going to go through here, highlight my first range, and I'll put a comma. And what do I want to have happen? So I'm going to put my quotation marks, and then I have to type in what I want. So I said greater than 22 here, and my quotation marks. Put another comma. What's my next criteria? Well, this is going to be my criteria here. And so I give it another comma. And now I'm going to use my wildcard in this here too. So I'll put my equal sign. And I just want last name Stark. So I'll put, just like I showed you before, put my asterisk in there. And I'm going to type Stark just like this. And my quotation marks and my bracket. So I should get, looking at this, I can see there's only going to be one above the 22 that is a Stark, so I should get one back. So I'll hit enter and I get one back on this one. So if I turn this number to 21, hit return, I get two back because now there's another Stark right up here that would fit in what I'm looking for. So let me give you one more example how to use this multiple criteria. If we go equals, this time I'm going to go, so we'll go COUNTIFs again, and I'm going to be looking at anybody in the north with sales above we'll say equal to or greater than 2000 in this case. So I'm going to go to my first range here. So my first range, I'll just start my formula here. And so this will be my first range. And I'm going to be looking for anything in the north. So I'll just go and type north. And remember, you can use cell references, but I'm typing and you have to use the quotation mark. What's my next criteria? Well, it's going to be right in here. So I put my comma again. And what am I looking for? So I use my quotes again. I'm looking for anything greater than or equal to then, we'll say 2000. So I'm going to put in my 2000 here and my quotation marks and my parentheses, and I'll hit enter and I get two. So it was picking from this one right here. And if we were looking for anything above 2000 from the north, you can see this one would be two. This one's below. So I can go back and adjust these at any time if I was looking for a different number. So if it was going to be 2100 here, it should drop by to one because this wouldn't be in what I was looking for. So remember, with multiple criteria, I could add more criteria too. I would just keep filling it out. So I hope you like this lesson today on how to use COUNTIF and COUNTIFs for multiple criteria and how to use the operation and wildcards inside it. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.